So hello everyone. So today we shall start with the experiment of venturimeter. Okay. So this is the part A experiments, which are under minor experiments. So this is the initial experiment, which is venturimeter. Okay. So basically, venturimeter is used to find the flow of a fluid. Okay. So let me explain the total setup of the experiment. Okay. So initially, this is the water measuring tank. So this is the U-tube manometer. So this is the pump. And this is the flow meter, and this is the venturimeter, and these are the valve connections with respect to different experiment. Okay, so, okay. So after setting and then reading here, we need to open the knobs of the venturimeter. So initially this is also an open condition. Okay, now we need to close the valve with respect to the manometer. So wait for some time. So until and unless the U-tube manometer readings will be stationary. Okay. So after few seconds, now you need to check the reading. So here you need to take the difference of the readings. Okay. That is value of H. That is head value. So that is the first setup of reading. So second setup reading is with respect to collecting tank. So here we need to measure the water, which is totally 10 centimeter we need to have. Okay. This is the scale. Okay. So this is the butterfly wall. Okay. Initially we have to close this. Okay. After closing that, the water will be rising in the tank. Okay. So that length then we can measure in this scale. Okay. So here you can take a standard value, that is 10 centimeter. Okay. So here the water will be rising. So for a 10 cm rise in water, what is the total duration taken in terms of seconds? Okay, you have to use stopwatch. For a 10 cm rise in water, what is the time taken for that? Okay, so this is the two readings which you need to take for the calculation. So like that, you need to go for a second reading. Okay, so like that you have to take total three readings for the calculation. Okay.
So hello everyone, so this is fluid mechanics and machinery lab. Okay, so today we shall discuss about experiment 1. So that is flow through pipes. So it comes under minor experiments, so which consists of three different experiments. So that is venturimeter, orifice meter and flow meter. Okay, so today we shall discuss about the first experiment, which is venturimeter. Okay, yes. So now this is the experiment 1. Initially we will go with the aim of the experiment, so that is demonstrate. Okay, so to demonstrate the use of a venturimeter as flow meter and to determine the coefficient of discharge. Okay, so next, apparatus. So which is used a measuring tank. So pipelines for venturimeter, tappings, ball valves for inlet and outlet flow, similarly manometer and monoblock pump and valves. Okay, so this is the pictorial representation of the venturimeter. So the water is coming at an inlet and this is the outlet. Okay, so this is the U-tube manometer because of the shape, and they have two different diameters or areas of. So this is inlet area and this is the throat area. It means that it is a reduced in contraction of the pipe. Okay, so due to that it will create the pressure difference. So that pressure difference is taken in terms of head. Okay, by the difference in the head of the manometer. Okay, so this is the basic concept of venturimeter. So let's see how the conduction of experiment in procedures. So initially fill the sump tank with clean water and keep the delivery valve closed. Okay, next, so connect the power cable with respect to the pump. Okay, next, switch on the pump and open the delivery valve to flow the water inside the venturimeter, so through the pipes. Next, open the ball valve of the inlet of the venturimeter. Okay, and adjust the flow through the control valve. So at the end of the experiment, I will be showing the next page itself. So this is the U2 manometer. Okay, these are the specifications of the experimental setup. So this is the power button for the motor, and so this is the device which is used for the flow meter. Okay, so for example, you can see here, adjust the flow. So we need to adjust the flow. So this is the control knob which is used to adjust the flow of water through the pipe. Next, we need to operate the ball valve, okay, which is fitted for the Venturi tapping. Okay, note on the differential head in the manometer reading. So for example, so this is the three different setups will be there. As I told you, so initial setup is for Venturi meter, orifice meter, and flow through meter, flow meter. So these are the knobs which are used for the inlet. Okay, so if it is parallel to the pipe, it means that it is open. Okay, so if it is perpendicular to the direction of the pipe, it means it is closed. Okay, similarly, this is the tank, as I told you. Okay, so this is the sump. So we need to fill the clean water inside. Okay, so initially the setup must be in a closed condition. Okay, so an open condition of the tank. So if it is parallel to the direction of the flow of water, it means the water tank is open. This is closed. Okay, so now this is the collecting tank. So next is flow, change the flow rate and repeat the experiment. Okay, so as I've shown in the video, so we shall have the calculations part. So we need to take the readings with respect to the water level in the collecting tank. As I told you, 100 mm. Okay, so it is actually 10 cm, we can take it as a 100 mm. Okay, so three different times for 100 minutes, sorry, 100 mm. So what is the time taken? What is the time taken? That is, we have to take with the stopwatch, 18 seconds. Similarly, from the U2 manometer, we have to take the readings. Okay, so that pressure difference will be, for example, I will take, okay, so that is 94 is equals to 186. This is the total head difference from the manometer head. Similarly, for the next, if you vary the flow meter, you can take the 24 seconds. It will take time. Okay. Similarly, you need to take the pressure difference of the head. So that is 102. Similarly, you have to take the 100 mm. That is 32 seconds it will take. So what is the value? 24. This is the pressure difference. Total head, you can take in terms, it is a total head. Okay. So these are the data we have to take it from the measuring tank. This is the area of the measuring tank, center of the gravity. And D is the Venturi diameter, that is throat diameter. Capital D will be the inlet pipe diameter. Okay. So here we need to calculate. So before that, I will explain you the theoretical discharge. Okay, so this is the formula which is used for theoretical discharge, and this is the formula which is used for actual discharge. Okay, so here A1 and A2 represents the inlet and outlet section of the Venturi meter area. Similarly, H is the head loss. Head loss is calculated using this formula, and actual discharge is calculated using this formula. A is the area of the measuring tank, R is the rise of water level for a time T seconds. Okay, so ultimately this is the formula which is used to calculate the coefficient of discharge, that is actual discharge by theoretical discharge. Okay, so now we shall calculate one of the formula. Okay, with by using one reading. Okay, so that is, initially I will take first reading as, that is H is equals to 186 mm. Okay, so we know the theoretical discharge is equals to A1 A2 root 2GH by root of A1 square minus A2 square. Okay, so initially we need to calculate the diameters, that is A1 is equals to pi by 4 D square, that is pi by 4. What is the value of diameter of the throat? That is 25 mm. Calculate in centimeters, it is, okay. So here we will be getting the value as 4.9 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter square. This is A1. Similarly, A2 is equals to pi by 4 d square, that is pi by 4 into 12.5 into 10 raised to minus 3 square is equals to 1.22 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter square. Okay. Now we need to calculate the value of H, that is head loss. The formula is rho of Hg minus rho of water into capital H, that is head. Similarly, rho W into 1000. Okay. So what is the value of density of mercury? That is 13600 minus 1000 into 186 into 10 raised to minus 3. Similarly, 1000. Okay. Now what is the value of this? We will be getting as 2.34 meters H. Okay. So this is the value of H. Similarly, you can take the values in this format to find the value of this thing. So we don't have this formula. Okay. So this is the formula. So once you get the value of H, now you can calculate the value of Q theoretical. Okay. Q theoretical. That is, what is A1? 4.9 into 10 raised to minus 3. Similarly, into 1.22 into 10 raised to minus 4. Okay. Root of 2 into 9.81 into, what is the value of H? 2.34. Divided by root of 4.9 into 10 raised to minus 4 square. Minus 1.22 into 10 raised to minus 4 square. Okay. So you will be getting the value of theoretical discharge as 8.54 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter cube per seconds. So this is the theoretical discharge of the water through the pipe. Okay. So this is the total readings with respect to HS 186. So you can see for 186 it has been done. Similarly, you have to do it for 108, 102 and 48, okay. So, I will write it as Q theoretical 1 here. Similarly, I will write it as Q theoretical 2, okay. That is for 108. 6.32 × 10⁻⁴ m³/s. Similarly, Q theoretical 3rd one, okay, for 3rd head. That is 4.3 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter cube per second. So this is 2 and this is 3. Okay. So these are the values for theoretical discharge. So now we need to find with respect to the actual discharge. Okay. So now actual discharge. So what is the formula for actual discharge? Q actual is equals to A into R divided by 1000 into T. Okay. So what is the value of area of the tank? Okay. So area of the tank is taken as 0.12. What is the rise R? R is nothing but the rise of the water level in the tank. That is 100 divided by 1000. So R is multiplied with divided by 1000 means that it is converted into meters. Again, don't divide it by 1000. So what is the time taken initially for 100 mm rise of water? Okay, that is 18 seconds. Okay. So Q theoretic, Q actual. So what is the value of initial term? That is 6.67 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter cube per second. So similarly, you have to go for, this is T1, this is T2, this is T3, okay. So you need to substitute and you need to find the value of Q actual 1, 2 and 3, okay. So the values will be 5.5 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter per second, meter cube per second. Similarly, third one is 4.3 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter cube per second. Okay, so now actual discharge is done. So now we need to find the value of CD1. CD, what is CD? CD is nothing but Q actual by Q theoretical. Okay. So now you need to take back the formula. So what is Q actual 1 here? That is, I'll write it down here. CD1 is equals to 6.67 into 10 raised to minus 4 divided by. So what is the value of Q theoretical 1? That is 8.4 into 10 raised to minus 4, right? 54. Okay, you will be getting the value of CD1 as 0.78. Okay, similarly, you have to do it for CD2. Okay, so that is 5 into 10 raised to minus 4 divided by 6.32 into 10 raised to minus 4. That is the value of CD2 will be 0.79. Similarly, value of CD3, 4.3 into 10 raised to minus 4 divided by 4.3 into 10 raised to 3.75. Okay. Similarly, you can take it here. 3.75 into 10 raised to minus 4. 4.3 into 10 raised to minus 4. That is 0.86. Okay. So we got the values of 3 CDs. So now we need to take the value of average CD, that is CD1, CD2, CD3 divided by 3. Okay, so that value will be getting as 0.7. Okay, so this is the value which is required. Okay, so now we need to write down the value coefficient of discharge as 0.7. okay, so this completes the value. Similarly, you need to draw the graph. Okay, so I will explain you how to draw the graph. So you can take it here, x-axis. Okay. So here we need to write Q theoretical, which is meter cube per second. Similarly, you have to write here Q actual, is meter cube per second. Okay, similarly, you can write the values of reading. That is 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Similarly, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Okay, now you need to mark the values with respect to theoretical versus actual. So what is the first point which we got? That is 3. Similarly, 4.6. Okay, so now just draw this value. Okay, so now you need to take the value as a slope. Okay, so now just take down the value. Slope is equals to 4 into 10 raised to minus 4 divided by 4.6 into 10 raised to minus 4. I've taken the same value. So this will remain as Q theoretical, this is Q actual. Okay, slope is equals to Q theoretical by Q actual. That is 5.5 into 10 raised to minus 4 divided by 4 into 10 raised to minus 4. We'll be getting as 0.7. Okay, so this is the graph which we need to draw. Okay, so this completes the experiment of